Ether Delta just got fined. Who's next? Is it Binance, KuCoin, Huobi, Gemini? The SEC is laying down the law. Stay tuned for another episode of No Futtin' News. What's up, Crypto Space? This is your host, B Roots, with another episode of No Futtin' News. And what do we have today? Like I said earlier, the SEC is laying the smackdown on all exchanges coming soon to an exchange near you. What exchange is that going to be? Is it going to be Binance? We don't know. Is it going to be Huobi? We don't know. KuCoin. It's getting crazy. Let's get to it. U.S. SEC charges fines EtherDelta founder with operating unregistered securities exchange. The U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission, also known as the SEC, has charged Zachary Coburn, the founder of crypto token trading platform EtherDelta, with operating an unregistered securities exchange, a press release by the SEC reveals Thursday, November 8th. EtherDelta, which served as a secondary marketplace for trading ERC tokens, allowed its users to buy and sell digital assets by means of an order book and smart contracts based on the Ethereum blockchain. According to the SEC, an 18-month operating period, EtherDelta's users placed more than 3.6 million orders for tokens, including ones that are considered securities by U.S. federal laws. And that's where I must stop right there for a second. What is a security? We still do not know. The SEC has, they know what coins are securities, but they have not let it out. However, they are fining these exchanges for dealing with securities, but they don't let out to the people which ones are securities. Let's continue. The regulator notes that most of the orders executed after the Dow report the SEC had released in June 2017. Under the law, EtherDelta had to register in US or to apply for an exemption. However, the SEC notes that the platform failed to do so. According to the regulator, EtherDelta founder Coburn neither admitted nor denied the findings, but he consented to cooperate and to pay the state $300,000 in unlawful profits. Moreover, he agreed to pay $13,000 in pre-judgment interest and a $75,000 penalty. The SEC also states that it would have imposed a greater fine if Coburn had failed to cooperate with the investigators. As Cointelegraph previously reported, the SEC suspended securities trading in October of Nevada-based firm American Retail Group, Inc. for making false claims that its cryptocurrency trading activities were approved by the regulator. In early November, the SEC reported that it's currently taking action against dozens of fraudulent ICOs. And the annual enforcement report for the 2018 fiscal year mentioned several listed ICOs, three of which defrauded investors of over a combined $68 million. So what do? We're stuck in the middle of this battle between the exchanges and the United States government called the SEC. You are new to the crypto space, you need to learn how to get your money That's not money. Get your cryptocurrencies and your tokens off the exchanges, because the SEC is coming to lay regulation down on this space. This is no FUD. This is not to scare anybody, but this is what's happening today and in the future. There will be no EFTs and no Lambos and no excitement without regulation. Get the coins off the exchanges. If you leave them on there, the SEC could take them down. We don't know who's next. It could be Binance, like I said, Huobi, it could be KuCoin, any of these top exchanges. If they decide not to work with the SEC, we have no idea what can happen. So if you don't know, if you don't have a wallet or anything to put your coins at, right there. Nano Ledger S. Get yourself a Nano Ledger S. Get your coins off the exchanges and trade safely as soon as you get your trades done. Well, thank you for watching another episode of No FUD News. Don't forget to give me a like, Spike. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed to me yet, and hit that bell for more daily news. Till next time, peace to the Middle East.